We're going to make a folded rim on this basket. And the spokes are 1/4 inch flat oval. And then the inside piece we're going to put is 1/2 inch flat. And according to your pattern, it could be a different size. It could be 3/8, could be 5/8. To give it a little bit different look. This is what we're going to do today. So these spokes I've gotten wet under some hot water, so they're good and flexible. And this 1/2 inch piece is wet. It doesn't have to soak very long, just enough to give it a little flexibility. And then I'm going to lay this on the inside. It's going to lay on the inside of all the spokes, just about 1/4 inch above the last row of weaving. And then I'm going to clip that. I'm just going to let it lay there and hang out for now. When we get closer to the end, then I'll decide how much we need for the overlap and the cutting. But that'll wait. So once you get this in, from the end, skip over about 5 or 6 spokes. And then you're going to roll around to the right and bring that out. You don't need to tighten these first two down very much. Okay. Now that's how you start. Do 2, and then we're going to start the process of doing all the rest of the sections. So you take the one on the left, slide that behind the next spoke standing up, hold it, then bring that one you just went behind. That's going to wrap around everything, tighten down, and then you're going to trim right between that folded one and the next one standing up. So take the one on the left, slide it behind the next one standing up, hold it, and then wrap it around everything, tighten down, and then trim right in between. You don't want to have it too long and have it hanging up on the next spoke. And you want them kind of consistent. So if you trim them halfway each time, they'll all be about the same. You want to keep this 1/2 inch just above that last row of weaving. Don't let it slide up, and don't try and pack it down too much. So left behind the one on the right, hold it, wrap, tighten it down, and trim. You're going to do that same thing till you get almost all the way around. We've been doing this folded rim, and when we started, I said to just leave this inside piece hanging in there. Because if you trim it when you start, chances are after you do this folding, it sucks up the gap and you find you might have cut it too short. So now I'm about 2/3 of the way around, and now I can see about how much I need to leave for the overlap. So this is the point when I'll cut that and then clip that together, and then when you get to that point, you'll catch those two pieces together as you fold the rim. Okay, now we can go back. Folding and tuck. We're now down to the end. And when you have the last two sticking out, you can see everything's folded so you don't have anything to go behind. So you're going to start from the left, and I'm going to fold it over and look at where it's going. It's going to go under this one that you see there's nothing behind there, but it's already folded down. So to make it easier, pre-cut. So I want to go behind there. I'm going to cut it and then use your bent tip packer. This is why you didn't want to tighten it down too much. You want to be able to get it up and slide it under. Just have that come up. And then this one will go behind this last one that doesn't have one behind it. Now, if it is too tight, you can kind of back it out from where it was tucked. Slide it in there. Be patient. Just work it in there. And then we tighten that piece down. And then it's ended.
Boy, howdy.